Hi everyone. Oh, sorry, I'm out of breath. Okay. Today I am going to show you my tutorial for my beautiful Mayflower design. This might be my favorite bracelet I've ever made. I absolutely love sparkly, crystally stuff. And I love how I was able to find all these little fake pearl beads to coordinate with the crystals, and I like it all. I like how I did it all in white, like my Mayflower kitty was all white, and she had one kind of greenish yellow eye, somewhere in between those two colors depending on the light, and a pretty blue eye. And she had five white little kitties just like her, two with the same eye color pattern, one with reversed, a little guy named Babe with two blue eyes, and the only female Pearl with green eyes. And the other three, the two that had her eye color, were Ash and Dude, were like twins. And then Moses with the other odd eye color. But all those beautiful kitties are in kitty heaven now. And I miss them. Anyhow, this is in tribute to my beautiful, precious little soulmate kitty. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pin bars across like that. And I will be giving you my input on this awesome product that Rainbow Loom just came out with, but unfortunately I will only be talking about the hook because these little doohickeys here, I have yet to try them. I'm a little bit scared at attempting something like that, but I know there's plenty of other loomers who have worked with those, so I will speak to you on that I'm familiar with. And as many have showed, I have to give it to Rainbow Loom. Their products are such high quality. I mean, this little pamphlet could just be some little cheap piece of paper, and it's beautiful. I mean, the colors are great, the quality is great, and yes, let's see, on this page we have Isalicious Designs, Looming with Cheryl, Expert Looms, and Crazy Just Might Work, Suzanne from Australia, and then the rest of us on these two pages. There's me. It's not an older picture, but it's a couple years old with a different hairstyle. I had allowed my hairstylist to experiment with on me. But yeah, how wonderful to think that all of our faces are going to be on shelves in Russia and all over the world, wherever they sell the Loomy Loom product. So real quickly, this was the prototype they sent, which is like a mini version. They asked us to critique it, and we pretty much, I think the only criticism that I heard others say was it was a little too short, especially when you're doing the hook only. It was just not quite long enough. So as you can see, they made it longer. The only thing, and I do think this was meant more for the, because it's, you know, double-sided, more for hook only than the full loom designs. It's nicer to use overall. It feels nicer in the hand and it works great. And of course it has an even better, you know, more precise hook than this one. Although this one's pretty good, pretty darn good as well. The only time where I would recommend this is when you're taking it off the loom and there's several bands on one, on pin. I mean, this is much shorter shank and, you know, you can't bend it. Where this one, I mean, this one, you can see it's got a little bit of a bend in it because I did push its limitations when I had very, very, very tight bands, you know, bunched up on one pin. So my recommendation, what I like to do is just use this until taking off the loom and you have to grab this one for those very heavy duty moments. So anyhow, yes, the I think others have shown you, but they've got these two things you can take off, the little nice cushiony silicone things that you can take off so you can use this. I'm so sorry, Rainbow Loom, I bent it. Oops, I'm a little tough on my things. Yeah, I would say that's the only thing, but probably because of its length, for what it is, it's not the hook's fault. It's myself pushing it beyond its limits. I don't think it's meant for that. That's what this one is for. So then you just pop these back on. And that's what's really, really nice about... I think I did this right. Did I do this right? I think I did this backwards. I don't know. I'm looking in the book real quick. And I think I did these backwards. So I think the little groovy there is where your finger goes. I suppose in the end it's whatever feels most comfortable. They go on nice and easy. And you just have this wonderful little hook. Love it, love it, love it. I mean, I think for the price, it's totally worth it, especially when you've got these other three things. And you know what? As most of you, especially the adult loomers, we bought these for our kids, and our only intention was to get on YouTube or whatever and see how it's done, show them so they can go do your little thing, and then we got hooked. But, yeah, now we're completely involved, so I would not be surprised if one day you see me making all kinds of these, because, you know, when you're creative, anything that you can do that's clever and unique and fun, it's a nice switch up. So anyhow, that's the Loomy Loom by Rainbow Loom. I totally recommend it. So here's my favorite. This was one of my originals where I've got a little bit different stitching going on. I was just practicing, but I kind of like the color. It's kind of interesting. And then there's this little piece, which I was showing some of my looming friends on DM, on Instagram, to see what they thought. And then this was also another one that I have posted on Instagram already. So, what one should I use? I should probably use, say, this one, so I can kind of, you know, do my A, B, C, and D. This is good. Oh, where's my little sample? Oh, man, I thought I had everything on me, but now I don't know where it went. I had a little sample about this long of what I had done. So for where this black and white LE bands in the center and the side, I am using these medieval, I think it's the turquoise 300 count. And here where I've got the silver, like the metallic, but not the LE metallic, I'm using they're kind of like an LE metallic. Now both of these are like mixed metallics, but these have a flat edge and these are the round ones. So I'm going to be using those there. And where the white, kind of little loopy, they kind of have a loop and they have these two little, like a V shape. I'm going to be using, I think this is caramel. I take it back. It's one of the darker skin tones. And then where I have the pink here, and on here I just used the solar clear, which kind of looks a little weird in the sun because they all turn bright pink, but it still looks okay because it's all pastel-y. I am using this, I think they're polka dot, they're a jelly polka dot with a little hematite, like a discus-shaped bead. So I've done it without any beads. I've done it with beads only in the middle. I've done it with beads on both. So this time I'm just going to be doing beads on the outside. So let's get to work, and hopefully I won't mess up band placement, because in all my practicing I've done it so many times. Okay, we will start out by placing one A-colored, A-positioned A-color here, and then place two like this, and then match the mirror image. It doesn't look right. It's an intruder. It's a gorgeous but inappropriate Persian band. Okay. Then, forget the A, B, C's, and D's because I messed up. Just this one first. And then we are going to place the same band or whatever you want to use up the middle. If you want to use something different, like here, up the middle, I use the same as the ones that were going sideways like this, and not the same as the border. I used the black LEs for the border. So this going up the center is what you will see here. I'll probably just stay on camera to do this because it shouldn't take too long. Then I'll get you started on the next section. Yeah, so what have I been doing lately? Not too much. I think I'm still recovering from the Christmas shopping spree. I had 2 or 3 days there, which were way outside my tolerance, and yeah, it takes a long time. Oh, sounds like hubby's home. So I'm going to have to hurry up. Because he's, as I've said before, he's a little noisy. And there's the whiny pup. Okay, let's pretend we're done that so we get on to the next. The next thing you're doing is placing one like this. Then pull it over. And placing one on top of it. Pulling it over. And you're going to do this over and over again all the way up the loom. I mean, you can place it like this, especially if they're the LEs, but if they're a flat band, generally, I like using that because it keeps them from getting all twisted. There he is. Okay. So I hope you got that, right? Just one side, the other side, all the way up as far as you can go. Okay, I'll be back with the placement of both of those. Alrighty. I actually found, here's my little sample. I used the burgundy instead of the skin tone. But, and I just switched to the burgundy here. I was trying the hematite round beads in the middle, but I'm just going to do with the sides. So, don't pay attention to those because we haven't put those on yet. But up the center, I think you're supposed to do it all the way to the end. Or that's how it looks, you know, at the end of how long you want to make it. The next step is to take a band, whether you, oh, also, those first bands we put down here, the medieval turquoise, those could have had a bead on it like this, if, you know, you wanted it to look like this in the middle. I should have mentioned that, but I'm just assuming, I guess. So here is where you'd put the bead if you wanted beads up the side. So you're just going to do this all the way up on both sides. Very simple placement. My husband is such a night owl. It's like close to midnight and I hear him with the loppers out back. We have a bush that's pretty much blocking the pathway. It's gotten so bad. So he gets home from work at midnight, goes in the backyard, turns on the light, becomes landscaper. I guess as long as it gets done, it doesn't wake up the neighbors. Okay, so let's pretend, well, I am kind of done these. I'm just going to put these last couple ones on. I think I shorted myself a couple. So, just to pretend that all these are done. Okay, the next step, you're going to take whatever color, like the white here and the white here, actually where the brown is right here, and one, two, three, the three center, you're just going to single chain all the way up to the end on each, on columns two, three, and four. Okay, so just all the way, these three columns, all the way up to the last pins. And I'll be back to show you what to do next. This is definitely a multi-stage design. As you can see, I have those three little columns fully loaded. Now we will finish it off by placing one here and one here. And then we're going to cap this right now. Don't worry, I've got it all under control. Now we will take our hook and loom out each of these single chains. When I do this type of second layer of bands, they're kind of like a girdle or a framework for other bands. So I don't think I need to show you too much. Just that. Oops. It's going to be a single chain. One, two, and then up the center. So you work on those, I'll work on these, and I'll be back and show you band placement for the next bands, which I think are the last ones. And then, we'll see when we get back. Now that you've loomed up those three columns, rows, columns, turn it back around so the arrows are pointing away from you, and we'll do the final band placement, which will look like this. Okay. So you do this on both sides. So the first tip of the triangle will be on the second pin up, second in to the left, second into the right. And you will do it all the way up to, you cannot do these any longer. And I'll go off camera for a second because it just takes up more time and it's just going to be redundant. Alrighty, I think I messed up how I ended it, but I think I'll be okay. Now, I did have one of these that was from here to here, so I took that off. And this is how I'm ending it for now. I'm not going to finish right here because we're going to turn it around. So let you study that for a second. Of course, if I mess it all up, you'll never see this video. Okay, so that's how it looks. So you'll have your last diagonal band, your last triangle here, and then eventually we're going to be closing off the design by putting these bands here to here to here, you know, to the where the cap is. But for now, we need to do some more looming, so we're going to end it here. Spin it around, and then always starting from the inner part of the band, we're going to be looping this over itself. I think it's been labeled the cuff stitch. I'll bring the end out. Something I've been doing since pretty much the beginning of my designing. I don't know where I picked it up, but I know it's a popular stitch now. So again, I'll reach down, up, grab it without losing it. Oops, I'm using, where's my good hook? Lost my hook. I must have brought it with me. So I'll just use this one. So you do this all the way up both sides. Oops. Helps if I'm on screen. I'm going to do that again. Okay. So reach in here. Grab that, which is, of course, it's on top of this, so you won't be touching those triangle bands. Then reach down, grab the other half, and bring it over that way. And this is what it looks like on this side. Loomed in a few days, so it's quick. It's amazing how quickly we become uncoordinated when we're not doing this all the time. But anyways, it's really simple. You've seen me do this before. You've seen others do this before. So bring end out. So I think what happens if you did it from this way to this way, I think it falls apart. I know on some designs I've tried, you can't do it that way. So if it doesn't matter, it doesn't matter. But it does matter, better just go inside to outside because it's going to end up, you know. I know that way it doesn't fall apart. So I'll be back when that's done, show you how to finish it off, and then we'll start finishing the design. Get it all finished. It's not really that difficult, actually. It seems like it, but it's a pretty simple design. Alrighty. I've got all these looped out, then looped back. Turned it around one more time, back to arrows facing that way. And we need to do this. And this. And these last two, you're going to grab the cap, take it off temporarily so we can put these last two bands on. Put the cap back on, turn it around to loom, and then we are going to loom out those two bands. And now we'll do the other one. Okay. Now, before we do the middle bands, I'm actually going to be looming the border bands first. So we're going to reach down and we're going to take the corner of this triangle down here. This right here. We'll reach under. Grab it. And just pull the corner straight up. Hopefully you've got stretchy bands for this. If not, you know, just do it slowly. What I found when I had bands that, you know, I've inadvertently used that tend to snap in tight spots, I found that if I just slowly stretch it out very gently, it's usually when you go boom fast, that's when it it's more likely to snap. Just like our muscles, you want to stretch them out slowly and gently. If you ever snapped a hamstring or something from stretching too quickly or too forcefully, it hurts. I know from experience in high school, running down the hallway in stocking feet after school, me and my girlfriends, I jumped up in the air to do a split, and I splitted further than I was meant to split. And the hallways echoed in a horrible sound. And I think it's just been a few years. Well, actually, maybe because it's dry, but whenever it was like damp out, my back left hamstring would hurt. Yeah, I put my left foot out first and I split, as opposed to my right. What side do you do, cider? Okay, I guess I'm just doing this while I'm on camera. It's pretty quick. But you know what? I can pretend they are done because doing these borders will not interfere with what I'm going to do in the middle. So let's pretend I'm all done doing the borders. So the next thing you're going to do is you're going to start on one side. You're going to take the tip of the triangle in here. So do one side and the other, one side the others. Go all the way up the center. Cider again. If you didn't use overly stretchy bands, just be nice and gentle. I think most of the bands that tend to snap when you overstretch them are like some of the 300 count silicone bands. I love them. They make beautiful. They shape very beautifully, but you have to plan where and how you're going to use them and what stress will be applied against them. But sometimes the stretchiest bands will snap if it's a very rare defect. Okay, so let's pretend we've loomed all the borders up. We've done all the back and forth triangles. The last thing you're going to do is remember that it's almost the first bands we placed up the center. You had to reach all the way down. Oops, I forgot to do this. It's going to be a little bit out of place, but I don't think it's going to matter. Because this band that I'm going to do right now is going to be holding it all together. So the very last thing you do all your borders first, then do all the triangles, do one side, and then the other. I know I'm kind of backwards. Now let's pretend this is the end of the loom. I've done the sides, and I brought each triangle tip in, and then as I did this first one, now I do these. And those will be the last three things you do before taking it off the loom. So I'm going to finish those and be back, and hopefully I'm still kind of iffy on this whole color coordination, but I kind of wanted something kind of a little more masculine, less my typical color scheme. I do like blues and browns together. It's kind of like the sky, the earth, you know. It works, right? Okay, I've gone ahead and gotten most of this off the loom, and the last thing to do, if you haven't done so already, are these top border bands. And we have a small clip here, but I guess I'll have to make it do. Wish they had like little, pretty little metal clips. I think that would make our, you know, higher end designs with bling and everything look nicer. I know we often finish them off with toggles and clasps, but if, you know, you just wanted a slip-on bracelet with just this little clip here, I think it would be nice to have a full metal. Okay, so these are the pins. You don't want to use a thinner hook on. So I did work a little bit on one end to straighten it out. So these bands here, depending what kind, sometimes they're a little messier, like these brown ones are a little messier. The white ones here lay nice and neat, as did, I believe, these black ones. Yes. So just do a little bit of stretching to make them fall into place, and I'll be showing it to you. You know, I'll make a post a picture on Instagram when it's all neatened up. The band's all straightened out, but there you have it. Mayflower. This doesn't look much like Mayflower, but this one definitely does. And if I gave this to a guy, I'd say, hey, here's a bracelet. I don't know. I forget what name it is. All right. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe to Deb's Thing if you want to see more of my designs and be alerted of whenever I get around to getting one on, since I'm not very regular. And of course, check me out on Instagram @Deb's Thing, and I would love a follow. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.